Spanish earth is dry and hard, and the faces of the men who work that earth are hard and dried from the sun. This worthless land with water will yield much. For 50 years we've wanted to irrigate, but they held us back. Now we will bring water to it to raise food for the defenders of Madrid. Of Fuente Dueña, where 1,500 people live and work the land for the common good. It is good bread, stamped with the union label, but there is only enough for the village. Irrigating the wasteland of the village can give 10 times as much grain for bread, as well as potatoes, wine, and onions from Madrid. Is on the Taco River and the main high road that is the lifeline between Valencia and Madrid. All food for Madrid comes on this road. To win the war, the rebel troops must cut this road. plan the irrigation of the dry fields. They go to trace the ditch. This is the true face of men going into action. It is a little different from any other face that you will ever see. Men cannot act before the camera in the presence of death.
Largo. Buena deriva. Carguen.
The villagers in Fuente Dueña hear this noise and say, our guns. Front line curves north to Madrid. These were the doors of houses that are empty now. Those who survived the bombardment bring them to reinforce the new trenches. When you are fighting to defend your country, war, as it lasts, becomes an almost normal life. You eat and drink and sleep and read the papers. Speaker of the People's Army. It has a range of 2 kilometers. When these men started for the lines 3 months ago, many of them held a rifle for the first time. Some did not even know how to reload. Now they are instructing the new recruits how to take down and reassemble a rifle. This is a salient driven into Madrid itself when the enemy took University City. After repeated counterattacks, they are still in the Casa de Velázquez, the palace on the left with the 2 pointed towers, and in the ruined clinical hospital. The bearded man is Commander Martínez de Aragón. Before the war, he was a lawyer. He was a brave and skillful commander, and he died in the attack on the Casa del Campo on the day we filmed the battle there. The rebels try to relieve the clinic. Thank you. William, a boy from the village, writes home. Papa, I will be there in 3 days. Tell our mother. The troops are called together. The company is assembled to elect representatives to attend the big meeting to celebrate the uniting of all the militia regiments into the new brigades of the People's Army. The clenched fist of Republican Spain. Enrique Lister, a stonemason from Galicia. In 6 months of fighting, he rose from a simple soldier to the command of a division. He is one of the most brilliant young soldiers of the Republican Army. Carlos, one of the first commanders of the 5th Regiment. He talks of the army of the people, how they are fighting for Spanish democracy and for the government they themselves have chosen. Fighting together, we shall win a new, strong Spain.
Se construya una nación democrática, libre y pacífica, la España feliz y progresiva. Camaradas, el 5º Regimiento desaparece. ¡Viva nuestra capital, el Madrid invencible! ¡Viva el Ejército Popular, el Ejército de la Victoria! ¡Adelante por una España potente y feliz para la victoria! ¡Salud!
Jose Diaz. He used to work 12 hours a day as a typesetter before he became a member of the Spanish Parliament. Gustav Regler, one of the fine writers of Germany who came to Spain to fight for his ideals. He was gravely wounded in June. Regler praises the unity of the People's Army. The defense of Madrid will remind men always of their loyalty and courage.
Für seinen Heroismus, einen Gruß an seine Toten und heute an diesem Tage ein Gruß für den weisen Verzicht, den dieses Regiment von Revolutionären gegenüber der Notwendigkeit zeigt, die Volksarmee zu schmieden. Salut!
The most famous woman in Spain today is speaking. They call her La Pasionaria. She speaks of the new Spain. It is a nation disciplined and brave. It is a new nation forged in the discipline of its soldiers and the enduring bravery of its women.
Diversas como la valentía del miliciano en el choque y la emoción de nuestras agitadoras que al frente.
The loudspeaker broadcasts to the rebels. Living in the cellars of that ruined building are the enemy. They are Moors and civil guards. They are brave troops, or they would not have held out after their position is hopeless. But they are professional soldiers, fighting against the people in arms, trying to impose the will of the military on the will of the people. And the people hate them, for without their tenacity and the constant aid of Italy and Germany, the Spanish revolt would have ended 6 weeks after it began. This battalion goes on leave, and Julian, who is with them, has 3 days' leave to the village. Alba's palace is destroyed by rebel bombardment. Treasures of Spanish art are carefully salvaged by government militiamen.
Camaradas de la 12 bandera.
Os habla José Neiva. ¿Me conocéis? Me encuentro yo entre mis hermanos del ejército del pueblo, donde he recibido un trato excelente. Aquí no impera el trato bestial que nos dan en esas filas.
Madrid, by its position, is a natural fortress, and each day the people make its defenses more impregnable. Stand in line all day to buy food for supper. Sometimes the food runs out before you reach the door. Sometimes a shell falls near the line, and at home they wait and wait, and no one brings back anything for supper. Unable to enter the town, the enemy try to destroy it. This is a man who had nothing to do with the war. A bookkeeper on his way to his office at 8 o'clock in the morning. So now they take the bookkeeper away, but neither to his home nor to his office. government urges all civilians to evacuate Madrid. Where will we go? Where can we live? What can we do for a living? I won't go. I'm too old. We must keep the children off the streets, except when there is need to stand in line. Recruiting is speeded up by the bombardment. Every useless killing angers the people. Men from all businesses, professions, and trades enlist in the Republican Army. Meanwhile, in Valencia, the president...
Nos atacaron sin con el pueblo. Ignoraban la larga lucha que han seguido las masas españolas en contra de la tiranía. ¿Les sorprende su oposición al fascismo? Tanto como su gran auxilio a la capital, hasta en los pueblos más pequeños, en donde en este mismo momento...
...completar esta obra a tiempo para la nueva defensa de Madrid. Ya tenemos el aparato que se compró con el dinero que nos sobraba el año pasado, y desde luego, la disposición a trabajar. Solo nos falta el cemento, que en poco tiempo estará aquí. Thank you.
Julian catches a ride on an empty truck and comes home sooner than he expected. Julian drills the village boys in the evening when they come back from the fields. In Madrid, a future shock battalion of bullfighters, football players, and athletes is drilling. They say the old goodbyes that sound the same in any language. She says she'll wait. He says that he'll come back. He knows she'll wait. Who knows for what, the way the shelling is? Nobody knows if he comes back. Take care of the kid, he says. I will, she says, and knows she can't. They both know that when they move you out in trucks, it's to a battle. Death comes each morning to these people of the town, sent by the rebels from the hills 2 miles away. The smell of death is acrid, high explosive smoke and blasted granite. Why do they stay? They stay because this is their city. These are their homes. Here is their work. This is their fight. The fight to be allowed to live as human beings. Boys looked for bits of shell fragment as they once gathered hailstones. So the next shell finds them. The German artillery has increased their allowance per battery today. Before, death came when you were old or sick. But now it comes to all this village. High in the sky and shining silver, it comes to all who have no place to run, no place to hide.
Aviación! Aviación!
Aviación!
Aviación! Aviación!
Three Junker planes did this. Government pursuit plane shot one Junker down. I can't read German either. These dead came from another country. They signed to work in Ethiopia, the prisoners said. We took no statements from the dead, but all the letters that we read were very sad. The Italians lost more killed, wounded, and missing in this single battle of Brewega than in all the Ethiopian war. The rebels attacked the Madrid-Valencia road again. They have crossed the Jarama River and tried to take the Arganda Bridge. Troops are rushed from the north to the counterattack. village works to bring the water. They arrive at the Valencia Road. In the assault, where cameras need much luck to go. The slow, heavy-laden, undramatic movement forward. The men in echelon, in columns of six, in the ultimate loneliness of what is known as contact, where each man knows there is only himself and five other men, and before him, all the great unknown. Thank you. This is the moment that all the rest of war prepares for. When six men go forward into death to walk across a stretch of land and by their presence on it prove this earth is ours. Attack has been successful. The road is free. Six men were five. Then four were three. But these three stayed, dug in and held the ground, along with all the other fours and threes and twos that started out as sixes. The bridge is ours. The road is saved. Men who never fought before, who were not trained in arms, who only wanted work and food, fight on.